my next video lecture. In this video lecture, we will discuss difference between slip ring induction motor and spirit cage induction motor. Let us discuss some of the differences between the slip ring as well as spirit cage induction motor. We know that in case of induction motor, we have two different types of classification. One classification is the slip ring type of induction motor and another is spirit cage induction type of motor. So there are certain differences between both motors, so we will discuss one by one. Let us start with the construction. In case of slip ring induction motor, construction is complicated because of presence of slip rings as well as brushes. In case of spirit cage induction motor, the structure is simple and highly robust. Second part, that is the motor winding. In case of slip ring induction motor, it is similar to the stator winding. In case of stator winding, we have three-phase winding connected normally in start. So rotor winding also connected in start. In case of squirrel cage induction motor, it is a short circuited rotor and the short circuited with the end rings. Next topic is rotor resistance. In case of slip ring induction motor, at the slip rings, external rotor resistance can be added. But in case of squirrel cage induction motor, squirrel cage induction motor rotor is a short circuited, so external rotor resistance cannot be added. Our next topic, that is starting torque. In case of slip ring induction motor, starting torque is very high because external resistance at the rotor circuit can be added. While in case of squirrel cage induction motor, external rotor resistance cannot be added and the rotor resistance is very low. That is why the starting torque is comparatively very low. Our next topic is maintenance. In case of slip ring induction motor, because of slip ring and brushes, frequent maintenance is required. While in squirrel cage induction motor, construction is highly robust, so very less maintenance is required. First, in case of slip ring induction motor, because of higher maintenance and the presence of slip ring and brushes, cost is comparatively higher. While in case of squirrel cage induction motor, cost is less. Usage. Slip ring induction motor usage is very low, while squirrel cage induction motor usage is very high. Only 10% of the induction motors are of slip ring type, while 90% of the induction motors are of squirrel cage type. Efficiency. In case of slip ring induction motor, losses are high because rotor resistance is high, and that is why the rotor copper losses are very high. So efficiency is low. While in case of squirrel cage motor, rotor resistance is almost negligibly small and the rotor copper losses are very small, so efficiency is higher. Speed control. One of the methods of speed control is by rotor resistance. In case of slip ring induction motor, we know that the rotor resistance can be added and speed control is possible. While in case of squirrel cage induction motor, rotor resistance cannot be added, and by that method of speed control, we cannot do the speed control of squirrel cage induction motor. Application. Where high starting torque is required, we have to use slip ring induction motor. While in case of squirrel cage induction motor, comparatively low starting torque is possible, So application where we require comparatively low starting torque, we use a squirrel-ish type of induction motor. Some of the example of slippery induction motor, we have rush, train, elevators, etc., where we use a slipping type of induction motor, while we have lathe, drill machine, fan, blower, where we use a squirrel cage type of induction motor. So, for this lecture, we studied some of the differences between slipping of induction motor and squirrel cage type of induction motor. So, thank you very much.